When it was released a few years ago, the Taylor GS Mini quickly became one of professional music technology's favourite travel guitars. Since then, the range has been expanded. It's now available with either a Spruce, Mahogany or Koa top. I'm Sam.
And I'm Meg, and today we're doing a tonal comparison of these three similar but very different guitars.
So before we get cracking with our comparison, let's have a quick reminder of the GS Mini specs. The design is effectively a scaled down version of Taylor's Grand Symphony model, and they like to refer to the GS Mini as a modern day parlor guitar. With a 23.5-inch scale length, it definitely fits into the travel bracket. It's a lot smaller than a full size guitar, but if you compare it to other popular travel models, such as the Taylor Baby or the Martin LX series, as made famous by Ed Sheeran, you'll find that the GS Mini is a little bit larger. Regardless of which model you go for, every single GS Mini features a solid top, hand scalloped X bracing, and Taylor's unique relief route design. This is where a shallow channel is routed out on the underside of the top, loosening up the edge and generating extra flexibility without compromising structural integrity. This develops a greater bass response, more volume, but still maintains a really nice balanced tone. Whilst the tops may be solid, the back and sides of the GS Mini are a laminate construction. This is made from a core of poplar, sandwiched between two veneers of either sapele, Indian rosewood, koa or walnut, depending on which model you go for. And whilst it's true that laminate woods don't quite deliver as complex a tone as solid woods do, they are a bit tougher and are much more resilient to humidity changes. And I'd say that's a pretty desirable characteristic in a travel guitar. Plus, it helps to keep the cost down. The backs of the GS Minis are slightly convex. This helps to project the sound. They're unbraced, so they can move really freely. And when you combine that with the solid top, it allows these little guitars to deliver a much bigger sound than they really should do. All of the GS Minis are fitted with a really slim, comfortable sapele neck, a 20 fret ebony fingerboard, and a miniature headstock allows for access to the truss rod, and houses six high quality Taylor sealed tuners. The GS Mini is also available in a few different electro models known as the GS Mini E. These are fitted with Taylor's ES2 expression system, the same pickup and preamp system that you find on a lot of their more expensive guitars. When compared to conventional under the saddle piezo pickups, this unique three sensor behind the saddle system delivers a livelier and more organic sounding electro tone. For our comparison, we really do want to concentrate on the acoustic sounds, but to give you an idea of what the expression system's like, here's what it sounds like plugged directly into our recording gear. An absolute must for any travel guitar, all of the Taylor GS Minis come supplied with a really high quality hard foam padded gig bag, complete with shoulder straps and an accessory pouch. That will definitely protect the GS Mini and keep your guitar nice and safe. So, for our tonal comparison, we're going to be looking at three different models. We've got a standard GS Mini, which features a Sitka spruce top and layered Sapele back and sides. This offers a really nice broad dynamic range suitable for all playing styles. And we're going to be comparing that with the Koa and Mahogany models. The Mahogany features a solid mahogany top and layered Sapele back and sides, and it offers a slightly woodier, drier tone. The Koa, absolutely beautiful guitar, has a very similar tone to the Mahogany with a little more top end shimmer. Take a listen and let us know in the comments below which one you prefer. Thank you.
was a quick tonal comparison of the three most popular Taylor GS Mini models.
Let us know in the comments below which one you prefer.
Don't forget though, we've been playing three brand new guitars. I'll always tell my customers, the day you buy the guitar is the worst it's ever going to sound.
And that's because when a guitar's got a solid top, the older the wood gets, the more it matures, the more you play it, all those subtle tonal characteristics, overtones and harmonics start to emerge.
If you think it sounds good now, it's only going to get better.
But that's not all. You've also got to consider how the guitar looks. With woods such as these, every single guitar is going to be completely unique. Take a look at this Koa model. We've seen quite a few of these coming through, but this particular guitar is by far one of the most striking tops that we've seen so far. Absolutely stunning. So, we'll always advise getting down to your local PMT and checking a guitar out in the flesh. It's one of the gambles you do take when you're buying a guitar online. Obviously, you're still going to get the same quality, but you're definitely not going to be able to pick out the prettiest one. So, for more information on the Taylor GS Mini, visit www.pmtonline.co.uk and follow us on Facebook, facebook.com/PMT House of Rock.
Or better still, pop into your local PMT store. We've got shops dotted all over the UK with a huge range of acoustic guitars from Taylor, Martin, Gibson, Fender and many more. I'm the acoustic expert at the PMT Portsmouth store. There's someone like me on hand at every PMT store to help you find your dream acoustic.
So make sure to follow your local PMT on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram to keep up to date with all the latest products, special offers, news and events. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more like this. I've been Sam.
And I've been Meg.
And we'll see you next time.